are going to study a new chapter, oscillations. In earlier chapters in motion, we learned about rectilinear motion, motion of a projectile, uniform circular motion, now planet motion of planets around the sun, etc. Okay, and in your childhood, you must have experienced or observed your friends swinging on a swing. This motion is a repetitive and it is different from the motion of planets around the sun, isn't it? Here the swing moves to and fro from its mean position. So all these type of motion are included in periodic motion. So now we have to study the important topic, periodic motion. What is periodic motion? The motion which repeats itself at regular intervals of time is called a periodic motion. Any motion which repeats at regular intervals of time is called a periodic motion. Example, vibrating tuning fork, bouncing ball, ball moves up and down. Okay, it also repeats after regular intervals of time. Motion of a simple pendulum, then motion of planets or earth in its orbit around the sun, motion of hands of the clock, motion of child on a swing, motion of all planets around the sun. So these are the motion which repeats after regular intervals of time, and hence such type of motion is called a periodic motion. So what is periodic motion? The motion which repeats at regular intervals of time is called a periodic motion. Now we can see what is oscillatory motion. If an object moves to and fro or back and forth about a mean position, it is said to be oscillatory motion or vibratory motion. If the object moves to and fro, okay, to and fro motion is otherwise called back and forth. So such type of motion is called a oscillatory motion or vibratory motion. Example, motion of simple pendulum, okay, vibration of strings of sitar or musical instruments like guitar, etc. Then vibration of tabla, then oscillation of a mass suspended from a spring. If a mass is suspended from a spring and if a force is applied to the other end, it oscillates, okay, oscillation of the spring. Then vibration of the tuning fork. So these are all examples for to and fro motion, okay, or back and forth motion, and such type of motion is called oscillatory motion or vibratory motion. And all oscillatory motion or vibratory motion is always periodic in motion, because periodic motion means it repeats after regular interval of time. Oscillatory motion or vibratory motion, it also repeats after regular interval of time. So all type of oscillatory motion and vibratory motion are periodic. But a periodic motion may or may not be oscillatory. For example, planets are revolving around the sun. So it is a periodic motion, but it is not an oscillatory motion. Okay, so therefore we can say that an oscillatory motion or vibratory motion is always periodic, but a periodic motion may or may not be oscillatory. So circular motion is periodic, but it is not oscillatory. Now, is there any difference between oscillation and vibration? There is no significant difference between oscillation and vibration. Both are periodic motion, both repeats after regular interval of time. Both are to and fro motion or back and forth motion. But there is a slight difference between oscillation and vibration. If the frequency is small, we call it as oscillation. Frequency means number of oscillations in 1 second or number of periodic motion in 1 second is called frequency. If frequency is small, okay, so it takes some time from one point to another, it oscillates from one point to another. So if the frequency is small, such type of motion is called oscillation. For example, oscillation of simple pendulum, oscillation of branch of a tree. Okay, children. Now, if the frequency is high, that means oscillation is very fast. If frequency is high, we call it as vibration. For example, vibration of tuning fork, vibration of strings of the musical instruments, etc. Okay, so vibration of any material body produces sound. So we cannot see that material vibrate. So it is very fast. So if the frequency is very high, such type of periodic motion or such type of to and fro motion is called a vibration. So that is the only difference between oscillatory motion and vibratory motion. Both are to and fro motion, both are back and forth motion. But if frequency is small, it is called oscillation. If frequency is high, it is called a vibration. Now we can discuss the terms relating periodic motion. First term, time period. The smallest interval of time after which the motion is repeated is called a period. That means the time for one complete oscillation is called a time period. Now, in the case of simple pendulum, if the simple pendulum oscillates between the two position, this position is called extreme position. This is the extreme position, this is also called extreme position, and this position is called mean position. If a simple pendulum oscillates between the two extreme position, time for one complete oscillation, what is one complete oscillation from one extreme position and back to the same position is called one oscillation. If a bob is released from this point, it oscillates, go to the other extreme position and come back. So, time for one complete oscillation is called a time period. Okay. So, the smallest interval of time after which the motion is repeated is called a period, and its SI unit is second. Since it is time, its SI unit is second. Now, the second term is frequency. The number of oscillations produced in 1 second is called a frequency. Time for one oscillation is called a time period, and number of oscillations produced in 1 second, that is called a frequency, and it is usually represented by the letter nu. Number of oscillation produced in 1 second is called a frequency. Now, what is the relation between time period and frequency? We know time for one oscillation is T. Okay, time for one complete oscillation is equal to time period. How many oscillations are produced in T time? How many oscillations are there? One oscillation, isn't it? So, time for one oscillation is T, that means number of oscillation in T second is equal to 1. So, number of oscillations in 1 second is equal to time, number of oscillation in T second is 1, hence number of oscillation in 1 second is 1 by T, isn't it? From the definition, number of oscillations in 1 second is called frequency. So, the relation between frequency and time period is nu equals 1 divided by T. So, reciprocal of time period is called frequency. So, this is the relation between frequency and time period. And the SI unit of frequency is second raised to minus 1. Since it is 1 by T, so its SI unit is second raised to minus 1, and it is called a hertz. So, SI unit of frequency is hertz. Now, the third term is displacement. In early chapters, we defined the displacement of a particle to denote the change in its position vector. That is, displacement means the shortest distance between the initial point and final point. But here, in this chapter, in periodic motion, displacement refers to change in any physical property with the time. So, displacement is a general property here. That means, any physical quantity, if it changes with the time, it is called a displacement. For example, in oscillating simple pendulum, okay, in oscillating simple pendulum, we know it oscillates from one extreme position to another. It oscillates like this. Okay, if it is released from this point, you go to the other extreme position and come back. So, that is called oscillation. In simple pendulum oscillation, what changes with the time here? If it is released from this point, when it go down to the mean position, what happens to the angle? Angle decreases. At the mean position, angle becomes 0. Again, on the other position, if it moves in the other extreme position, what happens to angle? Angle increases. Again, reaches the maximum value. Then it comes down, means angle decreases. Okay. So, what happens to the angle? Angle changes with the time. Angle from the vertical changes with the time. And hence, this angle is considered as the displacement. Okay, children. So, in oscillating simple pendulum, what is the displacement? Angle changes with the time. From it moves from one extreme position to another extreme position, angle goes on varying. So, angle changes with the time, hence angle acts as the displacement. Now, another one, in the propagation of sound wave. Okay, in 9th standard, you have studied propagation of sound wave through a medium. So, when sound propagates through a medium, what changes with the time? Their pressure variations changes with the time. Okay, so there are high pressure regions. What are the high pressure regions called? Compressions. Okay, and what are the low pressure regions called? They are called rarefactions. Clear? So, when sound propagates through the medium, pressure variations varies with the time, or pressure variations changes with the time, and hence pressure variations can be considered as displacement. Another one, in the case of a block attached to a spring, for example, like this. In the case of a block attached to a spring and other end of which is fixed to a wall, the distance x from the mean position is the displacement vector. For example, like this, this is a spring and a mass is attached to one end of the spring and the other end is fixed. If an external force is applied and it is released, it oscillates like this. Here, what changes with the time? This distance x changes with the time. So when it extends means x increases. If it is released, x decreases. Again it decreases to it decreases way to a smaller value, then increase. So it oscillates like this. So what changes with the time? The distance x from the mean position varies with the time, and hence the distance acts as the displacement vector. Clear, children? So displacement vector can be considered as any physical property with changes with time. Any physical property which changes with time can be considered as the displacement in periodic motion. Mathematically, the displacement for periodic motion is represented as xt equal to a cos omega t, okay, where xt is called displacement, and here t represents displacement depends on time. We know that displacement is a physical quantity with depends on time, therefore it is represented as xt. A cos omega t, here a is called amplitude. Omega t is the argument of the cosine function, and omega t is called phase. Omega is called angular frequency, and omega is equal to 2 pi nu. You have studied angular frequency in circular motion, uniform circular motion topic. So omega is 2 pi nu, or nu is 1 by t, no? So omega equal to 2 pi by t. And the unit of angular frequencies, what is the unit of angular frequency? Radians per second. Frequency unit is hertz, and the SI unit of angular frequency is radians per second. Okay, children, so displacement of any periodic motion is represented as xt equal to a cos omega t, a is called amplitude, omega t is called phase, omega is called angular frequency. You will study more about amplitude, phase, angular frequency in the next topic.